The day's celebrations commenced with a march flag off at Nakasero Primary School, led by the Minister of State for Primary Education, Dr. Joyce Morigo Kaduchu, and another group from KCCA grounds, led by the Minister of State for Higher Education, John Chrysostom Muyingo, to the Kololo Ceremonial Grounds. At 11 a.m., the chief guest, His Excellency Jessica Alupo, arrived at the event. The event attracted the attendance of distinguished dignitaries, including senior government officials, UN partners, ministerial representatives, and education development
partners. Thank you very much for accepting the invitation.
In 1997, the government of Uganda initiated the universal primary education, which would subsequently be followed by the introduction of the universal secondary education in 2007. Focusing on the former, the 27 years have been characterized by a number of grievances, but the eventual harvest has equally been bountiful.
As we mark the International Day of Education today, we reflect on the 27 years journey of universal primary education in Uganda.
This phenomenal surge represented a remarkable 73% increase within a single year, showcasing the profound impact of UPE and USE in addressing social inequalities, particularly in providing access to education for girls and marginalized communities.
Uganda's Vice President, retired Major Jessica Alupo, commended the indispensable impact of universal primary education in the country and urged all UPE beneficiaries to turn their attained knowledge to the benefit of the majority of the population.
It is believed that the most impactful role of education in the pursuit of peace is its ability to empower learners to become agents of change in their communities. To those who have graduated, I thank you for forming the UPE Graduates Association and being good ambassadors of the UPE program. Thank you for the work you are doing to showcase the benefits of the UPE program to our country.
Despite an annual surging trend in the Ministry of Education and Sports budgetary allocations, which currently accounts for approximately 11.67% of the total national budget allocations, it is still insufficient. It's against this background that the European Union Ambassador to Uganda, Jan Sadek, urged the government to further increase UPE funding if the country is to realize further long-lasting results.
Uganda allocates a relatively low amount of resources to education compared to the needs of the sector, which could result in Uganda falling behind neighboring countries in education levels and ultimately losing out on economic opportunities as international investors look elsewhere to bring business and develop markets. We therefore encourage the government of Uganda to fulfill its pledge required by the Global Partnership for Education to increase funding for education.
As the country marked the 27th UPE anniversary, the government committed to better and quality education for all children across the country, as inspired by the positive results so far.
While notable progress has been made, challenges such as unequal access to quality education, pupil absenteeism, proficiency gaps, and school retention persist, highlighting the ongoing commitment needed to provide quality education to all children in Uganda.
27 years down the road, there is much to boast of, highlighting the fact that the post-UPE period witnessed a narrowing gap between the number of girls and boys enrolled in primary schools. The number of girls attending school has, however, increased, with the gender parity index improving from 0.88 in 1997 to 1.04 in 2021. Story compiled by Derek Asava for the news.